small boy, baby, tiny, tiny boy, does not know anything, does not even know ABCs, just knows belittle and nap. So pure.
These are common shore crabs. They're tiny, cute, have big pinchers, but they don't pinch. They love their belly rub, and they're excellent swimmers.
While house and pet sitting for a friend, I found this weird rock in the road 2 days ago. Meet Herbert. He's a giant land crab. He is eating and pooping just fine. Favorite food is pineapple, and I'm going to try to help him rehab and grow some legs and claws.
These are some of the common crustaceans of the North Atlantic. This is the green crab, a European species introduced to the United States in the early 1900s. The green crab is known for its anger and ferocity. And despite its name, this crab is orange due to the mating season. The Jonah crab is a native species. Unlike its friend the green crab, it is very docile and does not want to tussle. You can gender a crab by looking at its apron. The females have a larger apron to hold eggs.
Why do we always have to get involved? Can't we just do normal stuff that normal people do? Like, go for brunch?
What the fuck is brunch?
That ain't the tiniest freaking crab.
Did it just blink?
Where'd it go?
For those that didn't see my last video, I found this hermit crab in the middle of the beach in New Jersey. They're not even native to this area. So I'm creating a tank for it. I got some supplies for him. This is him in his water bowl. I actually made a mixture with cocoa fiber and sand. That's the best you can get for your hermit crab. Most people think this is a normal depth, but they actually need 6 inches of dirt so they can go inside and molt properly. I made some places so he can hide in and things to climb on. I made a fresh water bowl and made sure I put rocks in it so he can't drown, and added some chia seeds so he can have fresh food. So for his fresh water dish, I used this Polar Spring natural water. I added this plant. Hopefully he doesn't eat it, but it's very likely that he will, and added some fake ones as well. Then afterwards I just sprayed everything down, and don't forget about the salt water dish. I bought this water solution at PetSmart, and eventually I'll be getting him new shells and some friends.
You got me jumping like wanna hold you down.
The courtship between a green crab is very intimate, very beautiful, and very powerful. The large one is the male crab, and the smaller one is the female crab. The female crab is just molted. Molting must occur before mating occurs, so the sperm plug can be inserted into the female crab. The male crab cuddles the female crab and turns it upside down in preparation for mating. Here you can see the male crab cuddling and holding the squishy female crab, preparing to mate. Even when separated, the male crab tries to corral the female crab into its arms once again. And once they are together, mating will occur. Very beautiful and very powerful.
This animal probably saved your life and you don't even know it. This is a horseshoe crab, and yeah, it's not a crab. They're actually related to spiders and scorpions. So why are they important? They have blue blood, which contains amoebocytes, which are basically white blood cells. I know this sounds like chemistry class, but bear with me, this is gonna make sense. We use their blood to make limulus amoebocyte lysate, or LAL for short. Unlike the LAL you might be used to, this LAL actually comes through. Seriously, Lakers, what the fuck? So in the medical field, we used to have no way of knowing whether a vaccine or a medical tool had bacteria on it unless we tested it on a whole lot of rabbits. We use this LAL because it creates a gel-like cocoon around any bacteria on a medical tool. Basically a fire alarm for endotoxins. This means that if you get a vaccine or a flu shot, you can be sure you're not going to get infected because of these guys. This means we kill less of these, but there's a downside. It takes a lot of horseshoe crabs to supply us with enough of their blood. We harvest about 500,000 of them a year. The harvesting process involves draining them of 30% of their blood and returning them to the wild. So what's science to us is alien abductions to them. Also, they don't always survive after being returned to the wild. Now they're a step away from being endangered because we take so many of them. They've been around for 450 million years. They've had to put up with a lot of nature's BS, so it's going to say a lot if we're the ones that take them out.
Watch this. Boop-dee-dee-scoop. Scoop-dee-dee-whoop. Whoop-dee-scoop-dee-poop. Poop-dee-scoop-dee-scoop-dee-whoop. Whoop-dee-scoop-whoop.
So looking at this gigantic, expertly decorated 10-gallon tank, you're probably wondering what kind of exotic beasts I have in here. And the answer is simple. One very spoiled bastard.
Hello, today we're going to be going over a great way to kill your hermit crab. If your tank looks anything like that, good job, you're doing so great. Ooh, this is also another great way to kill your hermit crab. Just keep it in here, it has great humidity. Oh yes, and if you're feeding your hermit crab any sort of pellet food, good job, you're killing them. Or if you think that they drink out of sponges, just keep doing whatever you're doing. They should be dead pretty soon.
Where you going, little guy? You little stinky man. Little stinky baby man. Little stinky.
Stinky boy.
Stinky.
Nobody thinks what I think.
Hi all, today I'm going to show you what I feed my 8 hermit crabs. My cat helped me pick their powdered food and she chose the Flounder and More by Tiny Town Crabs on Etsy. Next, I give them a pellet. Today is the Thrive Hermit Crab Pellet Diet. I only give them like 3 or 4 pellets a day. Next is their veggies. Today is carrots and bell peppers. One is getting a bigger portion because the crabs are bigger. Next is their protein. Today, they get eggs and a frozen blueberry. I give them a frozen one because by the time they're ready to eat it at night, it has thawed and it stays better. Next is their dessert. Today, they're having worm castings by Tiny Town Crabs on Etsy. She has a phenomenal shop. And next is their calcium. Today, they each got a bit of cuttle bone. And last is their staples, which is a piece of romaine lettuce and some chia seeds. They really love chia seeds. That's all. Thanks for watching.
I am lost.
Upon first glance, it may appear that there are 3 crabs in this container. However, this crab is just molted. Crustaceans grow through molting and shedding their exoskeleton. Very beautiful. Very powerful. You can tell this is a molt because there's nothing inside the shell and the eyes are clear. Very beautiful. Very powerful. This is the squishy crab that is just molted. It is very soft and fragile. It must be protected at all costs. In the coming days, this crab will harden up and be less vulnerable to predation. Very beautiful. Very powerful.
If you flip over a rock at the beach, you might find a common shore crab. Even though they have big, scary-looking pinchers, they hardly ever pinch people, and they do love belly rubs. Crab kisses. Mwah.
Welcome to Jurassic Park.
Life could be a dream. Life could be a dream. Do, 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 shaboom.
Life could be a dream if I could take you up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the
君の虜になってしまえばきっとこの夏は充実するのもっともう戻れなくたって忘れないで。
I have a pet hermit crab, and he doesn't get too happy with me. He's actually quite mean. Watch this.
Oh! Oh, oh, ow! Oh, is it, oh! Oh! Oh!
That is a giant hermit crab. Oh my god.
Oh! Dude! Oh, holy crap!
Wanna see me do my dance in these $1,000 pants? Don't disrespect me and my mans. Bam! Whole lot of chops on your ass. Tramp! Dollars on your head. Snitching ass nigga ass mama to the feds. Little brother, big brother, side I got the dress. DZDT.
It is time to check the drains once again. So looking in this first drain, we actually found a green crab in the drain again. So this was just a little female green crab, as you can see from her apron on her stomach, and then we just put her in the crab collection. Looking at the next drain, we found two more green crabs. I believe it was a male and a female, but they weren't mating. They were just hanging out together. So we grabbed them, and we put them in the crab collection. And then a first for the drains was a small little rock crab. These look a lot like Jonah crabs, but you can tell the difference because they don't have black tips on their claws. So yeah, pretty cool.
Dude.
Oh, hi Jake. What are you doing here?
Hey guys, I'm messing with one of my tanks, so I just thought I'd show you. This is just regular play sand. It's play sand from the store I bought. When you stick your finger in it, the hole automatically refills, right? But this is Eco Earth mixed with play sand. And when you stick your finger in this hole, the hole stays. So the reason that we use this is because whenever they dig down and they molt, they need to create a little pocket under the sand. That's why we don't use just this, because it'll suffocate them.
9 reasons why the horseshoe crab is actually pretty cool. It probably saved your life. I made a video about this, but long story short, the medical industry uses their blood to test for bacterial contamination in medical instruments. So basically, if your parents got a flu shot this year, this guy might be the reason you're not an orphan. Number 2, they're old. They've been around for 450 million years. Keep in mind, modern humans have been around for 200,000, which means we've done a lot of damage in a relatively short amount of time. Number 3, they're just weird. They have 10 eyes, 12 legs, blue blood, and their legs are right next to their mouths. Yeah, Gabriel had a ball with this one. Number 4, their blood is worth $60,000 a gallon. You know what you can do with that kind of money? That's like 2 semesters of college. The sad thing is, I'm only kind of exaggerating. Number 5, they're not crabs. These walking fossils are basically ancient spiders with tails. Number 6, they're completely harmless. That tail isn't poisonous, it just uses it to get back on their feet if a wave flips them over. Number 7, the babies swim upside down. I have no idea why. Number 8, a female can lay 100,000 eggs in one breeding season, which helps single-handedly feed migrating birds. Number 9, they have annual beach orgies during the full moon. Basically every musical festival ever.
This Jonah crab looks peculiar. It has black spots all over its shell. This Jonah crab has shell disease, but it will go away once it molts. It will survive and prosper. Very beautiful. Very powerful.
We were at the beach. Everybody had matching towels. Somebody went under a dock, and there they saw a rock. It wasn't a rock. It wasn't rock.